Hi everyone, this is Nico71 and you're watching a design secret of the Fiat 500, with the complete story and design process on this creation. This creation is a Lego Technic replica of the Fiat 500F from 1965. After completing my replica of the Citroën 2CV and Mary, I had many other small iconic cars in mind to do, which include this lovely Fiat 500. Now it is done. It features steering, working two cylinders engine, torsion bar suspensions, openable elements and detailed interior. It is equipped with the 43.2mm tire. It gives a 1 to 11 scale for 26cm long, 11cm wide, 11.5cm 8 and weighs half a kilogram. It is fun to see that this Fiat 500 replica matches approximately the scale of this Ford 150. It was a very tiny car at this time. But before we start, I just wanted to thank you for the reception of this video, despite my French accent. You are many to watch my videos without being subscribed. So please, if you like my work, do not hesitate to subscribe to my YouTube channel. The Fiat 500 is a rear engine 4-seat small city car that was manufactured by Fiat Automobile. It was launched as the Nuova 500 in July 1957, as a successor to the 500 Topolino. It was an inexpensive and practical small car, measuring 3 meters long and originally powered by a 479 centimeters 2-cylinder air-cooled 13 horsepower engine. With a weight of 470 kg, the little engine has enough power to move the vehicle to a maximum speed of 95 km per hour. It is considered one of the first purpose designed city cars. The Fiat 500 was a huge success with 4 million sales units and was manufactured by other companies under licenses like Polski, Ster, Neca or NSU. Regarding the Lego replica, I have chosen the F model which came in 1965 because of the door which opened in a correct way, and the lack of the big chrome front and rear bar which will be hard to reproduce on the L model for instance. The first obvious function are the openable element. The door can be opened, revealing a detailed interior with front and rear seats, dashboard, gear shift lever, but also handbrake and some detail on the central console. The front bonnet can open and be locked with a small hood rod, which reveals the fuel tank. On the original model, there is also a spare tire, but not on my replica due to the available space. To finish with the openable elements, the rear hood can be opened, which reveals the detailed working two-cylinder engine. The second function is a steering. It is operated by the steering wheel, which is connected to a lever with two universal joints and connect to the right steering knuckle with a 6L rod. Then, an underneath 9L rod connects the left steering knuckle, but there is no end of God steering. The interesting features of this creation is the suspension. Indeed, the model is equipped with independent torsion bar suspensions with swinging arm. It enables a small travel suspension when the scale doesn't authorize to have a big shock absorbers. The Citroën 2CV and Mary have shock absorbers but placed horizontally in the chassis, which was not possible on this model. Consequently, each swinging arm is mounted with an axle which cannot rotate on an extremities and create the torsion bar. Of course, considering the small travel and the weight of the model, there is no wear or damage on the axle that is used the elasticity domain of the raw material. To finish with the functions, the right rear wheel is connected to the two cylinders engine which bring motion to it. The left wheel is not connected as there is no differential because of the lack of space due to the suspension. In any case, it is a great addition compared to my previous medium scale vehicles, as there was no fake engine on this creation. You can also note that the crankshaft axle is also the suspension articulation. To finish, the engine is detailed with exhaust, ignition coil, cylinder head with oil filler cap. The small fan of the left is also powered by the engine through a rubber band. Usually, with cars, I start by the bodywork, but not this time. Indeed, I have started by the chassis to be sure first that it's possible to create it. It had to have the steering and suspensions on the front axle, but also the transmission and the suspension on the rear axle, plus the cantilevered engine. I have started by creating the chassis with the functions and then start the bodywork. The bodywork used a lot of building technique to have good proportions. Indeed, at this scale, sometimes you can't settle for the classic stud grid. That is why I have used a lot of parts to create half stud caps to have the correct proportion and position. Half beams are used, for instance, on the underside to hold the soft axle, in order to have the correct shape on the mudguard. These connectors complete the design and fills the gap caused by the half stud gap. Same technique for fixing the front and rear bodywork with these parts. Half stud connectors are used to attach the roof assembly and have the correct length of the different side parts like the windshield or the rear window. Other even-hole constructions are used on the front assembly to adjust the wall elements, as well as on the rear with the light and the hood. To finish, you can note that on each side of the roof, I use massively beam 2L to create the rounded shape of the roof. It was a bit tricky to find the correct solution which also matches the rear and side windows, but it was really important to me because having a flat roof would look terrible for this vehicle. After completing the bodywork, I have created the interior which is rather simple but full of detail. Indeed, to compare with my other medium scale vehicle, I wanted to go further. That is why I have used many non-technic parts to create the correct shape for the elements. It includes, for instance, the dashboard, the central console with the gear shift lever, the box and handbrake, but also under the hood with the fuel tanks and the central part of the hood. Consequently, the model has 964 parts, which is huge for a 26 cm long vehicle. After finishing the red version, I wanted to propose another color. Considering the used parts, I was able to switch color to white with some part changes. You can get the building instructions on my website, and the models are also for sale on Bilkamok, which included the genuine LEGO parts plus the PDF instruction. It is available in red and white version. All the links are in the description. Of course, the model has its limitations. For instance, I am not entirely satisfied about the anchor point of the windshield and the side of the roof, which doesn't look so homogeneous. Other drawback is a lack of homogeneity between the doors and the side rear panel, which don't have the same beam orientation, creating a visual break on the side. On the doors, the two L beams which create the bed line of the car are not locked and can rotate. And the last drawback is a lack of rigidity of the rear part due to the half stud cap fixation. Nevertheless, I am really happy with the design, which I find good and recognizable, with the overall shape and detail, and it is packed with many interesting functions to play. It is always a compromise to create something in LEGO, especially at this scale, so I am happy with the result. Thank you for your attention. If you want to see the original video, please click on the recommended left video. I also put another interesting video if you are new on my channel. Have a look at the link in the description. Please consider subscribing if you like my content. Take care, play well, bye.